Biosecurity measures at ostrich farm. Like other poultry birds, ostriches are vulnerable to a wide range of bacterial and viral diseases. The best way for prevention of diseases is application of biosecurity measures. Following biosecurity measures should be carefully be considered at the ostrich farm. Avoid anything being brought onto your farm. For vehicles, construct a vehicle dip where the wheels of the incoming vehicles have to pass through an authorized disinfectant. Try to prevent further movements of the incoming vehicles by designing parking near the opening gate. In any case, the person with appropriate footwear should pass through a foot dip containing a disinfectant. Clean and disinfect the house properly to give the chicks disease-free environment and good start. The shelter should be designed so that birds must enter confidently. Here, as you can see, an ideal farm depicting inside and outside floor for the ostriches. Next is the brooding management. Temperature at the bird level should not be less than 95 Fahrenheit during the first week. Reduce it to 85 Fahrenheit thereafter, and after week 3rd, the temperature should be near about 80 Fahrenheit. For the chicks, they really need little space during their first 4 weeks of age. A cemented floor of 250 square feet is sufficient for 50 ostrich chicks aged between 2 to 4 months. Afterwards, 80 to 100 square feet per chick at 12 months, they are adult ostriches. Ideally, the chicks should be kept in groups of 20. They like company, but they also should not be overcrowded. If you have 8% chicks mortality in ostriches, you are doing exceptionally well. If you have chick mortality of under 20%, you are doing well, and the industry averages anything around 40% and upward. Place feed in bowls in rubber tires for growing chicks. You can also use a plastic pipe cut in half held against the wall. It is better to fill feeders half full. Add vitamin supplements to chicks' diet for the first few weeks. Put something shiny into the water for the first few days. Some producers give each chick a dose of beneficial bacteria flora at hatch. One person is capable of managing at least 50 birds. Chick starter rations very high in protein are not recommended because very high protein diets may be associated with leg abnormalities in turkeys. Breeder rations contain additional calcium. These diets are based on limited scientific nutritional research. Therefore, addition of roughage source such as alfalfa hay also advised. To solve the problem, the Rifa College of University of Sciences, Lahore, Pakistan have formulated starter, grower and finisher and also breeder rations according to the exact nutritional requirement of ostriches. These rations also have cut down the need of lucerne feeding. Next is the vaccination. The areas where infectious diseases are common, vaccination with proper vaccines can help to avoid the prevalences of disease and consequent economic losses. Vaccination should be carried out according to the regulations and recommendations of manufacturers. Newcastle disease may cause extensive damage and mortality in ostriches. Ostriches should be vaccinated against ND inactivated Lasota via eye drop, wingtip or spray into the eye at the age of 3 and 6 weeks, and subsequent subcutaneous injection of an inactivated emulsified or alum precipitated at Lasota be given at the 3 month age and 6 month of age. Then repeat the vaccine each 6 month interval thereafter. Vaccination should be repeated at 6 month of age and once a year thereafter in breeding flocks. H7N1, H5N9, H5N2 and H9N2 are most commonly pathogenic strains of avian influenza for ostriches. Autogenous inactivated oil-based vaccines against influenza can induce good immunity. And here is the vaccination schedule. Necrotic enteritis, 6 days, 7 days, 4 weeks, and at the age of 7 weeks is done. At the age of 6 days, enterotoxemia oil 0.5 cc subcutaneous. At the age of 7 days, lamb dysentery 0.5 cc subcutaneous, and at the age of 4 weeks, enterotoxemia alum 1 cc subcutaneous, and at the age of 7 weeks, lamb dysentery 1 cc subcutaneous. Next vaccine is for anthrax. In areas where it exists, a single dose of cattle anthrax vaccine is effective. Avian pox, at the age of 2 weeks, commercial fowl pox vaccine by wing web puncture. Next one is ND. At the age of 3rd week, inactivated Lasota oil based 0.25 cc in the wingtip. And next one will be at the age of 6 weeks, inactivated Lasota oil based 0.25 cc wingtip. And then at the age of 3 months, its dose will be 1 cc in the wingtip, and at the age of 6 months, inactivated Lasota oil based 1 cc in the wingtip.